Welcome you once again in geological knowledge. So in the sequence of the discussion of combined geoscientist main examination series, today we will not discuss any topic related to the papers or the exam point of view, but today we will have a look on the syllabus of combined geoscientist main examination. So you all know that this is the stage second, and the papers will be of descriptive type. Here the objective type questions, they will not be there. So you have to answer the questions in the descriptive type. Okay. So our discussion will be wholly on the syllabus, the important topics related to your syllabus, and what are the important topics from the exam point of view. Okay. So you all know that is all the topics included in the exams. So question will not be asked from the all the topics. Okay. It may be asked from the topics, but the important topics, that is from where the questions are asked regularly. If you see the previous year question papers, though the pattern has been changed, but syllabus is more or less same. There is not a drastic change in the syllabus, as you can see, as we will discuss that's the point of our discussion today. So on the basis of the previous year question paper, you can analyze that what types of questions are being asked and what is the pattern of the question paper. Means you will have to identify, you if you have seen the previous year question papers, you will know that is the pattern is there. The first question that will be compulsory type, where I think 8 or 10 questions, generally 10 questions will be there, and you have to answer these questions in about 40-50 words, not more than that. And the question number 1 or the part A, that will be compulsory, and then 5 units will be there, that will consist of 30 marks each. Okay. And in one section, suppose if we talk about section A, so there will be I think 2 questions, question number 1 and question number 2. And generally what I have seen in the previous year question papers, so question number 1, that will consist of 2 parts, part 1 and part 2. Okay, so part 1 will be descriptive type, and part 2 will be, there will be sub parts like 1, 2, 3, 4 or A, B, C, D. Okay, and the question number 2, that will also be in the same pattern. Okay, so you have to answer only one question from the given 2 questions, and I think where the question consists of some parts like question number 1, part A, part B, then in part B you will see 1, 2, 3, 4, some short note types question. Okay, so that we will discuss it one by one, that how you have to answer the question paper and what are the precautions you have to take care when you go for the exam hall. So firstly we will discuss in detail the syllabus, that is what are the key factors or the key points, topics related to your exam point of view. So section A, as you know, that is consisting of physical geology and remote sensing. Okay, so firstly we will discuss physical geology. So as you can see, the topics are evolution of the earth. So in the evolution of the earth, we will talk about that how the earth has evolved, the several theories, nebular theory or the nebular hypothesis and some other hypothesis that will consist, and the earth's internal structure, as you all know, that is very important topic from the exam point of view. I think if the question is asked, suppose in 3 consecutive years the question is in the physical geology section, you will see the question related to internal structure of the earth every second year. Suppose in 2018 the question was asked, there may be chance that in 2019 this question from the internal structure of the earth has not been asked. So again in 2020 the question will be there. Okay, either it will be in the short form, short note type, or it will be in the compulsory type. Okay, but that is very important topic from the exam point of view. And the other factors or the other topics are earthquakes and volcanoes, principles of geodesy and isostasy, the weathering processes and the products, that is also important. Each and every topic is important. Don't take is that if I am saying that this is important topic, so that doesn't mean that other topics are not important. All the topics are important, but the most important topics from the from where the questions are being regularly asked, so these topics are always important. And weathering processes as well as the products. And the next and another very important topic, that is the geomorphic landforms formed by the actions of rivers, wind, glaciers, waves and groundwater. I think in 2019, I have seen the previous year syllabus, then waves and groundwater, I think that was not included in that syllabus, but now this has been included. So you have to prepare that landforms formed by the action of rivers, wind, glaciers, waves and the groundwater. Okay, so all three types of landforms, erosional, depositional as well as the transportational. Okay, features of the oceanic landforms, sorry, features of ocean floors, continental shelf, continental slope, continental rise. Okay, the concept of landscape evolution, that how the landscape have evolved, the Planck's concept. Okay, and other concepts, Planck concept is very important. I think in question has been asked in 2018 or 19. So, and major geomorphic features of India, coastal, peninsular and the extra peninsular. That is also important topic from the exam point of view. The coastal landforms, peninsular landform and the extra peninsular landform. Okay, the landform means the hills, the mountains, like, and the coastal if you talk about, so coral reefs, the Sundarban Delta complex. Okay, so these are the important topics from the exam point of view. And next is the remote sensing. Remote sensing in electromagnetic spectrum or EMS, that is very important. Electromagnetic bands in remote sensing, this is also very important. Means what are the bands in the electromagnetic spectrum which are generally used, like for the band for the visible light, for the infrared radiation, for the radio waves, okay, or for the gamma rays. So these bands are there, and question has been asked in the previous exams, and that is important for exam point of view. The spectral signature of soil, rock and water as well as the vegetation. Thermal near infrared, thermal near infrared and the microwave remote sensing, so that is also important. Okay, the questions has been asked in the previous exams. Digital image processing, DIP, you all know that is very important, that it's not too tough for one to understand or one to revise. The Landsat IRS, Indian remote sensing, as you can say, and Indian remote satellite and spot characteristics and their uses. Aerial photos, types, scale, parallax, relief and displacement. So, and the elements of image interpretation. So in remote sensing, if I have to choose the important topics, that is the aerial photos. In aerial photos, that their types, their scales, parallax, relief displacement, and another very important topic, that is elements of image interpretation. Okay, and thermal near infrared or the microwave remote sensing. One DIP, digital remote sensing, digital image processing, that can be useful for the compulsory type. Okay, so questions will be there either in the long question or there will be in the short note type. Okay, and secondly we will talk about section B, that is of structural geology. And you all know that is question will be asked from each and every unit, so you have not to skip any unit. Okay, there will be option for the answering purpose, means there will be two questions and you have to answer only one question, but you will have to
study each and everything, because you don't you cannot predict that which question will be asked in the which unit or in which point. Okay, so firstly we will discuss the the topic is principles of geological mapping, that we have discussed in the detail, and kinematic or the dynamic analysis of deformation, stress strain relationship for the elastic, plastic and the viscous material, that is important topic from the exam point of view. Measurement of strain in the deformed rocks, that is also important. Structural analysis of fold, cleavage, budding, lineation, joint and fault. So this is one of the very important topic. I think question will be there from this topic, that is the structural analysis of fold, cleavage, budding, lineation, joint and fault. Okay, I think in 2018-19 the question was there from classification of fold, Ramsey's class 2 fold classification. Okay, and next is stereographic projection of linear and the planar structures. So that is also important, because the question will be there, I think question will be there from this stereographic projection. You will be given a problem, okay, of a nulla cutting or a coal seam bed or any other inclined or the horizontal or the vertical bed. So the data of the strike and dip, that will be given, and you have to calculate the dip of the that bed or the that coal seam and successively plot that data on stereographic, means stereographic that net will not be provided, you have to plot it roughly on the notebook, your answer notebook. Okay, and superposed deformation at micro scale, dynamic and static recrystallization, controls of strain rate and temperature on development of microfabrics. So this is a new topic. Even I don't have any idea what type of question will be there from this topic. In the previous 2-3 times when the syllabus has been modified, this topic has not been there. This is the new topic, I think. And then the very typical and very famous topic of structural geology, that is the brittle and ductile deformation or brittle and ductile shear zones, time relationship between crystallization and deformation, calculation of paleo stress, that is also important, and in which we have, I think we have discussed brittle and ductile deformation, shear zones we have discussed, and time relationship between crystallization and deformation, that we have also discussed. Okay, and calculation of paleo stress question can be there from this topic also. And thirdly, the section C that deals with sedimentology. So previously sedimentology was part of paper 2. Okay, now it has been included in paper 1. So classification of sedimentary rocks, the elementary texture, grain size, roundness, sphericity, shape and fabric. So that is important topic from the exam point of view. Quantitative grain size analysis, that is also important. Sediment transport and deposition, fluid and sediment gravity flows, laminar and turbulent flows, Reynolds number, Froude numbers, grain entrainment, Hazelstrom diagram, bed load and the suspension load transport. Okay, so that's quite long topic and it's very important. Each and every topic is very important. Fluid and sediment gravity flows, fluid and gravity, sedimentary fluid and sediment gravity flows, that has been asked in 2018, I think. And laminar and turbulent flows, Reynolds and the Froude number, that is very important. Grain entrainment, Hazelstrom diagram we have discussed already. And bed load and suspension load. And then sedimentary structures, in which the primary sedimentary structures, penicontemporaneous deformation structure, biogenic sedimentary structure, and I think these three. So in sedimentary structures, I think all the sedimentary structures cannot be asked in any exam. I think any one of them, like biogenic sedimentary structures, write a short note or just write three sedimentary structures formed from the penny contemporaneous deformation. So question can be asked in any form, but if you have studied the topic thoroughly, then it will not be tough for one to answer that question. And then the principle and application of PELEW current analysis means the what was the direction and the condition of the current previously. Okay, so that is also important. Composition and significance of different types of sandstone, limestone, banded iron formation, mudstone and conglomerate. Okay, so this is also a new topic. This was not previously included in the syllabus. Okay, but it's not tough, you can assimilate it. The carbonate diagenesis and dolomitization, sedimentary environment and facies models for fluvial, glacial, deltaic, siliciclastic, shallow and deep marine environment. So that was also part of syllabus in 2019. Okay, and that's not tough for one to understand, you can easily assimilate it. And carbonate platform types and facies models, sedimentation in major tectonic settings, that is also important. And principle of sequence stratigraphy, I think this is one of the most important topics. If I have to choose two or three topics very important for the exam point of view, then I will choose the elementary texture and structures, the primary sedimentary structures. Okay, sediment transport and deposition, that topic is also important. And the important one of the important topic, or the most important, that is principle of sequence stratigraphy. Okay, you will get a question, you will essentially get a question from this topic, that is the concept and factors controlling the base level changes, parasequences, clinoform, system tracts, unconformity and sequence boundaries. Okay, and then section D, that is paleontology, fossil record and geological time scale, modes of preservation of fossils and concept of taphonomy, body and icnofossils, species concept, organic evolution, Ediacara fauna, then morphology and time range of graptolite, trilobite, brachiopods, lamellibranchs, gastropods, cephalopods, echinoids and corals. So that you will have to read it out one by one. You can predict the what will be the pattern of the questions and what will be the important or the important areas for the exam point of view from where you will get question. So I think morphology and time range of these groups, that will be very important for the exam point of view. And evolutionary trends in trilobites, lamellibranchs, gastropods and cephalopods, that is also important. And one of the most important topic of paleontology, that is micropaleontology. Okay, you will get question both from micropaleontology and from the this morphology and time range of these groups. Okay, and in micropaleontology, what you have to study, that is methods of preparation of microfossils. Okay, means how the microfossils are prepared. Morphology of microfossil groups, foraminifer, osteochords, fossil spores, pollen and dinoflagellates. Okay, so you have to focus on the morphology, their significance, their uses, especially like we talk about question like application of foraminifers in petroleum industry, application of foraminifers in sequence stratigraphy or in stratigraphy or in structural geology. Okay, so in that case the question can be there. And Gondwana plant fossils and their significance, this is also very important topic. You can get a question from Gondwana plant fossils, either the upper Gondwana plant fossil or the lower Gondwana plant fossil. Okay, then vertebrate life through ages, evolution of proboscideans and equidae and hominid. Okay, application of paleontological data in stratigraphy, paleoecology and paleoclimatology. So that we have discussed, that is important topic and that has been included in the syllabus. And then mass extinction events.
Okay, so mass extinction, that is also important. You can get a question from mass extinction. Okay, the mass extinction at Cretaceous Tertiary boundary that we have discussed already. Okay, and then next one is, or the section E, that is stratigraphy. So principles of stratigraphy, codes of stratigraphic nomenclature of India, lithostratigraphy, biostratigraphy, chronostratigraphy and magnetostratigraphy. So that is important topic, and you can get a question from this area. And principle of stratigraphy, correlation, characteristics of Archean grain stones, granite, greenstones belts, Indian stratigraphy, in which you have to study about the geological evolution of Archean nuclei, Dharwar, Bastar, Singhbhum, Aravalli and Bundelkhand craton. Okay, so you have to have thorough study of all the cratons. Proterozoic mobile belts, in which Eastern Ghat mobile belt, Southern granulite terrain, Central Indian tectonic zone or CITZ, and Aravalli Delhi belt and North Singhbhum mobile belt. So in which I think Southern granulite terrain, that has been asked in 2018 or 17, you have to, I will suggest you to revise or just have a look on the previous year question paper, at least 5 or 6 years question papers. Okay, then you will get an idea that what are the pattern of the question and how the questions are being revised, whether they are being repeated or how they are being asked. Okay, what are the pattern? So that will be helpful for one to understand the procedure, that how the questions are asked. Okay, but these stratigraphy, in Indian stratigraphy, the cratons, all the cratons, Aravalli, Bastar, Dharwar and Bundelkhand, that all the cratons are important. And in Proterozoic mobile belt, Eastern Ghat mobile belt and Southern granulite terrain or CITZ, these three are very important. And the Proterozoic sedimentary basins, in which the important ones are Kadapa and Vindhyan, the Phanerozoic stratigraphy, Paleozoic, Spiti, Kashmir and Kumaon Himalaya, the Mesozoic, in which Spiti, Kutch and Narmada Valley and Trichinopoly, Gondwana supergroup, Cenozoic, in Cenozoic stratigraphy you have to study about Assam, Bengal Basin, Garhwal, Simla, Himalaya. Okay, and Shivalik group, that has been also very important. Generally in Shivalik group you will have to give the stratigraphy and the vertebrate fossils. Okay, the vertebrate flora and fauna you get in the Shivalik groups. Okay, so that is important. And you have to understand the type of question, that what is given in the question. Suppose you have to tabulate the flora and fauna, or the tabulate the stratigraphic sequence of Shivalik group, so you have not to write the answer in the paragraph or the bullets. You have to just make the table, just draw the table and write the sequence of the formations. Okay, and boundary problems in India, Indian stratigraphy, that is also important. In stage 2 or the geology paper 2, as we can see the section A, that is mineralogy, as you can see. So symmetry, motif, Miller indices and concept of unit cell and Bravais lattice, 32 crystal systems, types of bonding, Pauling rules and coordination polyhedra. So these types of bonding and Pauling rule is very important. I think this was not included previously, so now the question can be asked from this area. And the coordination polyhedra, that is also important. The crystal imperfections, defects, twinning and zoning, so that is also new topic, it was not previously included. The polymorphism, pseudomorphism, isomorphism and solid solutions. Physical properties of minerals, the polarizing microscope and accessory plates. Okay, so question will be there from all the topics like mineralogy and crystallography both. Okay, and physical properties of minerals, the optical mineralogy, in which polarizing microscope and accessory plate that has been included, and optical properties of minerals, in which you have to study about the double refraction, polarization, pleochroism, sign of elongation, the interference figures, and optic sign. So you will get, I think you will get one or two question, at least one question from this area, that is the double refraction, polarizing polarization, pleochroism, sign of elongation, means how the sign of elongation is measured in the uniaxial and the biaxial minerals, okay, and interference figures and the optic sign, okay. And then the important, one of the most important topic, that is structure, composition, physical and the optical properties of major rock forming minerals. You will get 101% one family from this area, that is olivine, garnet, aluminosilicates, pyroxene, amphibole, mica, feldspar, clay, silica and spinel group. Okay, so you have to study all the groups. Okay. Then geochemistry and the isotope geology. So in geochemistry you have to read the chemical composition and the characteristic of atmosphere, lithosphere, hydrosphere, geochemical cycle, meteorites, types and composition, Goldsmith classification of elements, fractionation of elements in the minerals or in the rocks, and Nernst partition coefficient, and partition coefficient for compatible and incompatible elements, Nernst, Berthollet partition coefficient, and bulk partition coefficient. Okay, Fick's law of diffusion and activity, composition relation, Raoult's and Henry's law of solubility or solution that we have discussed, application of trace elements in petrogenesis, the principles of equilibrium and Rayleigh fraction, rare earth elements pattern, EH and pH diagram, okay, electronic potential and the pH diagram, that is very important, and mineral stability, half-life and decay equation, dating of minerals and rocks with potassium argon method, rubidium strontium method, uranium lead and samarium neodymium method. Okay, so these isotope methods, these are very important. Petrogenetic implications of samarium neodymium and rubidium strontium systems, the stable isotope geochemistry of carbon, oxygen and sulfur and their application in geology. Okay, and monazite chemical dating methods. So few of the topics, they were previously in the syllabus, and some of the concept, some of the topics, they are new, they were not in their previous syllabus. Okay, so just you have to, syllabus is lengthy, but if you have time, just revise all the things which you have studied. And basically the meteorite part, that you have to cover thoroughly, and the classification of elements, that you have to, and trace elements, application of trace element, that is very important, and EHPS diagram, that is also very important, and one of the most important topic, that is half-life decay equation and dating of minerals. I think one method of dating that will be asked in the exams. And section C, that is igneous petrology, viscosity, temperature and pressure relationship in magmas, IUGS classification of plutonic and volcanic rocks, that is important, nucleation and growth of minerals in magmatic rocks, development of igneous structures, means how they are developed, magmatic evolution, and in magmatic evolution you have to study about differentiation process, assimilation and mixing and mingling process, types of mantle melting, batch melting, fractional melting and dynamic melting, that is very important topic. I think question from batch melting that has been asked in previously, I think 18 or 19, I don't remember the exact year. Then important topic, that is binary and ternary diagram, I think you will get one question from this area, that is albite anorthite, forsterite silica and diopside anorthite diagram. Okay, and in ternary, diopside forsterite silica and diopside forsterite anorthite and nepheline calcite and silica diagram, phase diagram and relevance to magmatic crystallization, petrogenesis of granite, basalt, ophiolite suits, comatite, syenite, boninites, anorthosites and layered complexes, and alkaline rocks like carbonatites, kimberlites, lamproids or the lamprophyres. Okay, so that is important. I think you will get a question from these rock systems like carbonatites, kimberlites, lamproids and lamprophyres. And mantle metasomatism, hotspot and magmatism, and large igneous provinces or LIP of India. Okay, so large igneous provinces, that is important in Indian context, you can get a question. And that then we will discuss, you will find the section D, that is metamorphic petrology, the limits and physicochemical controls, in which we have to study about the pressure, temperature, fluid and bulk rock composition of metamorphism, concept of zones, facies, isograde, facies series, geothermal gradient and tectonics of orogenic belts. Okay, so this topic is very important, the zones, facies, isograde and facies series. Okay, so from facies, metamorphic facies, you will get surely you will get a question either in short note type or in the compulsory question. Then structures, microstructures and textures of regional and contact metamorphism or the contact metamorphic rocks. Okay, that is also important. Then representation of metamorphic assemblage data, that is ACF, AKF and AFM diagram. Okay, equilibrium concept in thermodynamics, laws of thermodynamics, enthalpy, entropy, Gibbs free energy, chemical potential, fugacity and activity. So few of the topics that are related to geochemistry, these have also been included in metamorphic petrology. And tracing and chemical reaction in pressure temperature space, phase rule and mineralogical phase rule in multi component system, the Clausius-Clapeyron latent heat equation or Clausius-Clapeyron equation simply known as, and slope of metamorphic reaction. Okay, that is also very important topic. Heat flow diffusion and mass transfer in metamorphic activities, the Fourier law of heat conduction, geothermobarometry, mass and energy changes during the fluid rock interactions, Chernokite problems, formation of skarns, progressive and retrogressive metamorphism of pelletic, calcareous and basic rocks. So that is, that can also be important for the exams. And pressure, temperature, time path and tectonic setting. So PTT path, that is important. You can get a question, pressure, temperature and time path. Okay, either the clockwise or the anti-clockwise, both will not be asked. They will specify, okay, that you have to answer the clockwise or the anti-clockwise diagram. And then section E, that is geodynamics. So in geodynamics, you have to study about the phase transition and the seismic discontinuities in the earth or the internal structure, the internal structure of the earth. So interior of the earth, you will get in paper 1 in physical geology or the geomorphology you will get. And here in geodynamics, you will again get this topic. Okay, so you have to cover that topic in consideration of this topic, that is the phase transition and the seismic discontinuities in the earth and in the internal structure of the earth. Okay, so physical, chemical, all the properties you have to study about internal structure of the earth. And then seismic waves and relationship between VP, VS and density seismic and the seismic and petrological MOHO. Okay, so that is also important. And the rheology of rocks and fluids, Newtonian and non-Newtonian liquids, rock magmatism and its origin, polarity reversal, polarity polar wandering curve and supercontinent cycle. So supercontinent cycle we have discussed, continental drift, seafloor spreading, I think that is very basic, you have studied, you will have studied so many times, gravity and magnetic anomalies of oceanic floors and their significance, mantle plumes and their origin, means how the mantle plumes are originated, the plate tectonic, types of plate boundaries and the their interrelationship. Okay, so that is important topic, heat flow and heat production of the crust. Okay, so that is discussion about the syllabus of geodynamics or paper 2, and paper 3, that is geology paper 3 and hydrogeology, that we will discuss in the second part.